Good day, ma'am. I am Irish Nicole Aiden, and this is my audio visual presentation. The contents of my presentation are the RDA, RDA of the nutrient, nutrients requirements, and the answers. To start off, what is RDA? The recommended dietary allowance, or RDA, is the amount of nutrient and calorie intake per day, considered necessary for the maintenance of good health. It is calculated for males and females of various ages and recommended by the Food and Nutrition Board of the National Research Council. To know more, let us tackle the RDA of the nutrients. First, we have protein. Proteins are large, complex molecules that play many critical roles in the body. They do most of the work in cells and are required for the structure, function, and regulation of the body's tissues and organs. Its RDA is 0.8 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight. Next is vitamin A. Vitamin A is a nutrient that the body needs in small amounts to function and stay healthy. Vitamin A helps in vision, bone growth, reproduction, growth of epithelium, which are cells that line the internal and external surfaces of the body, and fighting infections. It is fat soluble. It can dissolve in fats and oils. Vitamin A is found in liver, egg yolks, and whole milk dairy products from animals and in fish oils. Its RDA is 900 microgram for men and 700 microgram per day for women. Next, we have vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 helps make red blood cells, DNA, RNA, energy, and tissues, and keep nerve cells healthy. It is found in liver, meat, eggs, poultry, shellfish, milk, and milk products. Vitamin B12 is water soluble. It can dissolve in water and must be taken in every day. Its RDA is 2.4 micrograms for those 18 and older. Next nutrient that we have is vitamin C. Vitamin C helps fight infections, heal wounds, and keep tissues healthy. It is an antioxidant that helps prevent cell damage caused by free radicals, which are highly reactive chemicals. Vitamin C is found in all fruits and vegetables, especially citrus fruits, strawberries, cantaloupe, green peppers, tomatoes, broccoli, leafy greens, and potatoes. It is water soluble. It can dissolve in water and must be taken in every day. Its RDA is 75 micrograms for women and 90 micrograms for men. Next is folic acid. Folic acid helps to make red blood cells. It is found in whole grain breads and cereals, liver, green vegetables, orange juice, lentils, beans, and yeast. Folic acid is water soluble, can dissolve in water, and must be taken in every day. Not enough folic acid can cause anemia, a condition in which the number of red blood cells is below normal. Diseases of the heart and blood vessels, and defects in the brain and spinal cord in a fetus. Its RDA is 400 micrograms for both men and women. Next nutrient that we have is calcium. Calcium is a mineral needed for healthy teeth, bones, and other body tissues. It is the most common mineral in the body. Its RDA for women ages 18 to 50 and men ages 18 to 70 need 1000 milligrams. Next, we have phosphorus. The main function of phosphorus is in the formation of bones and teeth. It plays an important role in how the body uses carbohydrates and fats. It is also needed for the body to make protein for the growth, maintenance, and repair of cells and tissues. Its RDA is 700 mg per day for adults. Children ages 9 to 18 is 1,250 mg, and children around 4 to 5 is 500 mg. Next, we have sodium. Sodium plays a key role in muscle contraction, nerve conduction, and water balance in the body. These are critical to bodily function and the maintenance of our blood pressure. The primary source of sodium in the diet is salt, or sodium chloride, which has been a safe part of our diet for millennia. Its RDA is less than 2,300 mg of sodium per day. The next nutrient that we have is potassium. Potassium is a mineral that your body needs to work properly. It is a type of electrolyte. It helps your nerves to function and muscles to contract. It helps your heartbeat stay regular. It also helps move nutrients into cells and waste products out of cells. Its RDA is 4,700 mg of potassium per day. Next is chloride. Chloride is one of the major minerals which our bodies need in relatively larger amounts to keep healthy. We can find chloride naturally in a variety of foods, but it's often common that we have it as sodium chloride, also known as table salt. Its RDA is 800 mg per day. Next is iron. Iron is a mineral that the body needs for growth and development. Your body uses iron to make hemoglobin, a protein in red blood cells that carries oxygen from the lungs to all parts of the body, and myoglobin, a protein that provides oxygen to muscles. Your body also needs iron to make some hormones. The RDA of iron in all groups of men and menopausal women is 8 mg per day. For premenopausal women is 18 mg per day. Next nutrient that we have is zinc. Zinc is a nutrient found throughout your body, helps your immune system and metabolism function. Zinc is also important to wound healing and your sense of taste and smelling. With a varied diet, your body usually gets enough zinc. Food sources of zinc include chicken, red meat, and fortified breakfast cereals. Its RDA for adult plus is 11 mg a day for men and 8 mg for women. Next is copper. Copper is an essential nutrient for the body. Together with iron, it enables the body to form red blood cells. It helps maintain healthy bones, blood vessels, nerves, and immune function, and it contributes to iron absorption. Its RDA for men and women is 900 micrograms per day. Next is iodine. Iodine is a mineral found in some foods. The body needs iodine to make thyroid hormones. These hormones control the body's metabolism and many other important functions. The body also needs thyroid hormones for proper bone and brain development during pregnancy and infancy. Its RDA is 50 micrograms daily for adult men and women 19 plus years, and 220 and 290 microgram daily for pregnant and lactating women. Next nutrient that we have is manganese. Manganese help your body utilize a number of vitamins, such as choline, thiamine, and vitamin C and E, and ensures proper liver function. Additionally, it works as a cofactor or helper in development reproduction, energy production, immune response, and the regulation of brain activity. Its RDA is 1.8 milligrams for women and 2.8 milligrams for men. Lastly, we have selenium. Selenium is an essential component of various enzymes and proteins that help to make DNA and protect against cell damage and infections. These proteins are also involved in reproduction and the metabolism of thyroid hormones. Its RDA for adult men and women aged 19 and over is 55 micrograms daily. Women who are pregnant or lactating need about 60 to 70 micrograms daily. To summarize the RDA, we have here the RDA of the nutrients. First, we have protein, 0.8 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight. Next, vitamin A, 900 microgram and 700 microgram per day for men and women. Next, we have vitamin B12, 2.4 micrograms for both men and women. Next is vitamin C, 75 micrograms for women and 90 micrograms for men. Next is folic acid, 400 micrograms for both men and women. And then we have calcium, women ages 18 to 50 and men ages 18 to 70 need 1000 milligrams. Next, we have here the phosphorus, 700 milligrams per day for adult. Children ages 9 to 18 is 1250 milligrams and children around 4 to 5 is 500 milligrams. Next, we have sodium, less than 2300 milligrams of sodium per day. On to the next batch, we have here potassium. Its RDA is 4700 milligrams of potassium per day. We have here chloride, 800 milligrams per day. Next is iron. All groups of men and menopausal women is 8 milligrams per day. For premenopausal women is 18 milligrams per day. Next is zinc. For adults 19 plus years is 11 milligrams a day for men and 8 milligrams for women. Next is iodine, 150 micrograms daily for adult men and women 19 plus years, and 220 and 290 micrograms daily for pregnant and lactating women. Next, we have copper. For adult men and women is 900 micrograms per day. Next, we have manganese, 1.8 milligrams for women and 2.3 milligrams for men. Lastly, we have selenium. For adult men and women 19 plus years of age is 55 micrograms daily. Women who are pregnant and lactating need about 60 and 70 micrograms daily. And those are the RDA of the nutrients. Next topic, we have the nutrients requirements. The nutrients requirements of an infant are energy, 92 kilocalories per kilogram, protein, 1.16 gram per kilogram, calcium, 500 milligram, iron, 46 microgram per kilogram. Next is children. Calories. The calorie needs for girls ages 4 to 18 range from 1,200 to 1,800 per day, while boys typically require 1,400 to 2,200 per day. Protein. Children ages 4 to 9 need 19 grams of protein per day. Carbohydrates. 130 grams of carbohydrates for children of all ages. Fat. 25 to 35% of their daily calories from fats. Next is adolescents. adolescent female require approximately 2,200 calories per day, whereas male adolescents requires 2,500 to 3,000 calories per day. Additional intake requirements include fat, calcium, iron, zinc, vitamins, and fiber. Next is for adult men and women. Energy allowances range from 2,300 to 2,900 kilocalories per day for adult men, and 1,900 to 2,200 kilocalories per day for adult women. Next is pregnant women. Vitamin D, 15 micrograms per day. Iron, 27 milligrams per day. Zinc, 11 milligrams per day. Phosphorus, 700 milligrams per day. Calcium, 1000 milligrams per day. Folate, 600 micrograms per day. Next and the last is lactating mother. We have vitamin D, 1000 micrograms per day. We have iron, 9 milligrams per day. Zinc, 12 micrograms per day. Phosphorus, 700 milligrams per day. Calcium, 1000 milligrams per day. Next are the answers. Question number 1. Which of the nutritional guidelines you have learned are you practicing consistently? The answer. On the national guidelines, I have a lot of things that I have learned that I'm consistently doing right now. But what I do the most is maintaining a healthy weight. I was constantly chastised for my body. Therefore, I started eating healthier food and doing some exercises that made me maintain a healthy weight. Question number 2. Which of these guidelines are not given much attention in your family? Why? Consumption of milk, milk products, and other calcium-rich foods is not really given much attention in my family because my family is not really fond of milk and milk products are rarely used in our home. Question number 3. In the AVP, make an audit of your daily food and take good for 1 week. Then, assess if your daily dietary intake is healthy. If the food you eat followed pyramid, the go, grow, and glow. And state the importance of consuming these kinds of food. On Monday, my breakfast was egg and rice. Lunch was battery and rice. Dinner was vegetable soup and rice. On Tuesday, my breakfast was hot dog, rice, and banana. Lunch was rice and fried chicken. And my dinner was rice, corn soup, and fried eggplant. On Wednesday, my breakfast was bread, banana, and hot chocolate. Lunch was steamed fish and rice. Dinner was barbecue and rice. On Thursday, my breakfast was boiled egg, banana, and rice. My lunch was noodles and rice. And my dinner was adobo and rice. On Friday, my breakfast was ham and rice. My lunch was meat and rice. My dinner was fish stew and rice. On Saturday, my breakfast was corned beef and rice. Lunch was rice and canton. Dinner was rice and shawmai. On Sunday, my breakfast was bread, banana, and choco. Lunch was rice and pork blood stew. Dinner was rice and noodles. I can say that my daily dietary intake is healthy because it is balanced and consists of foods that follow the go, grow, and glow principles. It is important to consume these foods because they provide us with energy for our daily lives, they help our bodies build and repair themselves, and they help us fight diseases. And that was all, ma'am. Thank you, and God bless everyone.